Welcome back to another Minecraft video, and in today's video we're gonna be doing something pretty crazy. Okay, we're gonna be seeing who is calling us in Minecraft. Luca, is it Luca? Is it SpongeBob? Is it Homer Simpson? Is it any one of these crazy people? I don't know, but we're gonna be figuring that out in today's video. So without further ado, let's jump right in. Don't forget to subscribe and keep notifications turned on to join the notification squad. So as you guys can see, we are here in this lovely Minecraft world. Now, of course, you might be wondering, Drewsmc, what are you doing? What are you talking about? Where are we? Okay, so first of all, as you guys can see, this is my new Minecraft base, okay? And this Minecraft base is going to be where we're operating our videos for. Don't worry, guys, you'll catch on. But long story short, guys, as you guys can see, Harold has given us today's task, okay? And today's task says, your phone may ring. Follow the poles. You must investigate. Okay, the journey does not seem dangerous. That is a little bit weird, okay? He says, today's task, your phone may ring. Follow the poles. You must investigate. So I'm guessing that we have a phone in here somewhere that may ring, and we're probably going to be experiencing some kind of phone call any minute now. And as you guys can see, the phone call is just right here. So of course, this phone call has just actually happened. And why are there two phones, guys? That is actually definitely weird. So I'm guessing that whoever called us just recently purchased the call. Not purchased the call, just placed the call. And I'm finding to wonder, how are we going to figure out exactly who called us? Now, my hunch tells me that it is most likely Luca that is calling us. But we don't know this for certainty, and we don't know who is actually calling us. So, Harold, can you give us any tips on who is going to be there when we go there? He says, three people are there. Okay, three people are here. Okay, so three people, okay. Who travels in threes? Well, the PJ Masks travel in threes. The Paw Patrol travel in threes. Luca and his friends do travel in threes. So we got three possible candidates that it could be. But we still don't know just yet. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to... Whoa. We're going to have to go outside, okay, of our secret base, okay, because usually we take a portal button, but there is no portal button. We have to just follow whoever called us. So, Harold, I'll be seeing you after the mission. And let's see where we can follow these poles. So I'm guessing what kind of poles we have to follow is going to be the telephone poles, and I can see one right there, guys. So that is pretty cool, and I don't even know why I'm in creative mode. So Harold switched me to survival mode. That was pretty cool. He's always helping us out, okay? He's basically our guardian angel. So let's continue going on. And what we have to do, guys, is somehow follow this place, okay? Follow these telephone poles to see where, okay, the people are. Now, I know if you don't know how telephone poles work, basically, in real world, guys, not even just in Minecraft, basically, telephone poles, okay, get connected by wires. And these wires connected so that when you do these calls, that's how, you know, stuff happens. If you've ever been in a neighborhood, you'll see, you know, telephone wires. You may even see some shoes above telephone wires, which is kind of a weird thing to happen. But you never know, you know what, you never know what you might see. So let's continue on, following on, and see where we can find out this secret place, guys. Because I know that things are probably going to get a little bit confusing because these telephone poles, okay, could go on for some distance. Yeah, let's continue on, and I think it is actually getting pretty dark. So I want to make sure that we don't hang out on the outside for too long because I got to figure out. So where's the next one? Okay, so as you guys can see, this biome is particularly one of the ones where it's more and more difficult. So I got to be careful to make sure I'm staying on the journey because if I don't, I can get lost very, very quickly, guys. So as you guys can see right here, we have another, I don't even know what this is. As you guys can see, these torches, not torches, these telephone poles are actually getting pretty hard to see. So let's continue going on to see if we can figure out exactly what's going on, because I'm not gonna lie, guys, I'm gonna see if I can do that, guys. Let me see. Okay, that's pretty crazy. I don't even know what that is. That is, oh wait, did I just see fire? Did fire? Oh my god, what burnt down this tree? I don't even know what that is. Okay, hopefully someone's house didn't burn down. So it looks like we're still gonna follow these telephone poles. And so far, it doesn't look like we've seen any clues or traces as to who it could possibly be. So far, the cold trail is still pretty cold. So I have been traveling for some time now, as you guys can see, and it looks like we are starting to get to the end of the journey because I've been traveling for maybe about 10 to 20 minutes now, and I honestly don't know what is actually going on in this crazy world. So let's open this place up right here, open this up right here, and let's continue to see what we've got going on because I really don't know, guys. Is this the end of the place? It looks like, how many telephone poles are there, guys? Let me actually go up to a tree because I think maybe this is the end, guys. Because look, there's nothing else out here at the edge. It looks like there's also a trapdoor down here. And if I look up, okay, and probably go into a tree, I'm not even sure how you climb a tree. See, I'm not a little monkey, okay? I can't climb trees, sadly. In fact, I wish I was a monkey. That would actually be pretty cool. Let's get one of these blocks. Oh my god. No, this is bad. This is bad. Did we just fall for like a booby trap? Oh my god, guys. I was literally just trying to build up to a tree, but it looks like we got some sort of structure here, which I haven't actually entered. So I'm going to be seeing if we can enter this structure, guys. So let's go ahead right now and let's get up here, guys. if we can go in here, okay? Because I'm not gonna lie, okay? I was thinking to myself that this place, I don't even know where it is. It is so far from our base and we may just need to get beamed back. Okay, so Harold, make sure you beam us back, okay? So let's open this up and let's go down here. Let's see what we got. Oh my God. Oh my God, guys. What do we have here? What is going on? Julia, what are you doing down here with a telephone? Oh my God. Have you been calling me? I think you guys have. Okay. It says, wow, how did you get in here? Well, I actually followed the telephone poles. And then when I was following the telephone poles, I saw this. And this is actually not a hidden base. As you guys can see, this trapdoor is pretty, pretty obvious. So yeah, you guys did a pretty terrible job at hiding this place from other people. So what is actually going on? Is this some kind of call center? Is this some kind of weird place? Because it doesn't really look like an entirely secret base. It just looks like a normal kind of place. So what is going on? This was a prank organized by Luca. Wow. Okay, that is something interesting. Okay, I did not realize that this was a prank organized by Luca. That is I don't know how to feel about that. Okay, I actually have no idea how I'm gonna feel about that. Okay, where is Luca right now? Okay, because I want to speak to this dude because he's prank calling me. Okay, especially Alberto. Oh, he's downstairs with Alberto. Okay, you know what, I'll see you after I go down here because I want to talk to Luca and see what he's up to. Okay, so Luca, what is going on, man? You got a nice secret area right here, but I see you. Wow, you actually found me. Well, yeah, I did actually find you. And you know, you got a nice bed right here, which I can't sleep in right now, but you got your phone. Okay, your phone that you've been using to prank call me every single time. Okay, I don't know if I like that. Okay, I don't know if I like you prank calling me so much, but what are you actually doing in this place? Okay, and why did you decide to call me? Okay, I decided to call you for fun. Okay, he decided to call me for fun, guys. Well, you know, I gotta respect the hustle, okay, just a little bit, but maybe, just maybe, hey, look at me, maybe you shouldn't just call people for fun, okay? But as you guys can see in this random world, I don't know why you're actually doing this. So let's take a look at what else you've got to say for yourself. Where is Alberto? Well, I thought he was down here. See, that's one thing. I saw the image of Alberto, and Julia also said Alberto is down here, but you're saying he's not down here. So what is actually going on? Where is the good man Alberto, guys? That is something that is actually very, very confusing. I don't know where Alberto is. You don't know where he is. Where is he? So I haven't seen him myself. Okay, so is he missing then? I'm guessing we need to see him. Okay, guys, so let's see if we can search the area, because by the looks of things, Alberto is, I don't even know, guys. I think he's in some sort of trouble, because by the looks of things, he's not here. And I don't even know if they know where he is. So let's see if we can see if we can find him. So if Alberto did get lost somewhere, maybe, in fact, we should probably go into a top of a tree, because the top of a tree is going to give us a nice vantage point, okay? And basically what a vantage point is, it allows you to see everything from a highest point, basically the highest point which gives you the most view of the area. And as you guys can see, my inventory is pretty poor at the moment. I'm probably going to lose my ability to run in a moment. So where on earth could Alberto be? Because right now it doesn't really look like this place is too crazy. So I'm wondering to myself, I think that Alberto may just be in the sea, because if he was on land, I'm pretty sure we would be able to see him. So let's check these pools and see if we can find Alberto, because maybe he might be in here somewhere. Is he anywhere nearby? I just have a feeling that he could be underwater somewhere, because you know, these guys are sea monsters and sea creatures, and anything that they do is definitely underwater. So that is something that I am going to be looking for in this world. Okay, guys, so I've been looking on the coastal beach and I think I've seemed to found something. Oh my God. Whoa, this is crazy. What area is this? Okay, I gotta make sure I don't get stuck here, because by the looks of things, that place looks like you're gonna easily get stuck there, but I think we should be fine. What is going on right here? Alberto, what are you doing down in this hole? Stuck. I don't even know what to say. What are you doing down here? He said, Urkel trapped me here. Oh my God, guys. Urkel and Scotty is still up to his crazy, crazy crimes. You guys know who that man is. Okay, so let's get him out of here. Let's mine this, mine that, mine that. And if we mine this last block, we should be able to float to the surface, both of us. Luca, Alberto, if you don't float to the surface with me, you're gonna die, buddy, okay? So I need you to float to the surface. Okay, if I mine this block, can he float? I'm not sure what's wrong with him, guys. Oh my God. Oh my God. Can you float to the surface? I think he should be able to if I mine these blocks, okay? Hopefully. Come on, Alberto. Come on, you can do it, pal. Oh, wow. I didn't even mine this block right next to him. Okay, come on. You can do this. You can do this. Oh, no. He's gonna die. He's gonna die, guys. Alberto. I'm pretty sure he's gonna respawn, though. So I'm pretty sure he'll be absolutely fine, even if he does die. So, yeah, he's probably gonna respawn. Oh, no. There he is. He came to the top just when it was necessary. As you guys can see there, Alberto comes to the shop just in the nick of time. Guys, I'll be seeing you tomorrow after I get beamed back to my house.